Shift F5 brings up the alarm screen. This is a demo screen that shows us things you can do when the alarm is detected. An alarm is just a tag that the Seymour Micro panel is monitoring. If that tag meets the condition set, the Seymour Micro reacts. In this example, we can set the alarm by clicking on F5 or this little alarm icon right here. When we do that, we get a flashing screen, a text message across the top of the screen, an alarm tone, and a flashing LED. Let's turn that off. This is screen 6, so let's go take a look at that and see how to set this up. This graphic is a dynamic bitmap that only appears when the lock tag is active. The way you do that is you only specify a bitmap for the on state, leave the off state blank. These are all just static text blocks with the alarm, this big pump failure message, and even this little note here. This is a static bitmap placed on top of a regular push button. That creates a graphic push button. Note that we can either move that graphic out of the way to get access to the push button, or we can simply push it to the bottom. This push button simply sets the alarm tag right here, and it also sets up the F5 key to do the same thing. When we're done, we simply push the push button to the bottom of the stack, and our alarm graphic comes back to the top. Now that our screen is all set up, we just need to set up the alarms. We do that under the Navigation Window's Function tab, Alarm Control Setup, or under Setup, Alarm Control Setup. In this dialog, we can create up to 16 different alarm conditions. We just select the tag to generate the alarms. We'll grab one out of our database here. Select the state that generates the alarm, on or off in this case for a discrete tag, and then just enable the options you want. You can turn on the beeps, you can have the LED blink on any function key you want, you can have the backlight turn on to any color you want, or you can have it blink between that color and another color. You can even have a banner message appear at the top. One note, the alarm tag doesn't have to be a discrete type. If we choose a numeric type, let's go find something that's not a discrete. Here's this V6000. Notice that this changes from on off to conditions. So the alarm is visible when it's equal to a zero, not equal to, greater than or equal to, etc. So you can choose any value you want, any condition you want for a numeric tag. Otherwise, everything else is the same. So, back to our example, I'm not actually going to use that tag we just created. Let's look at the tag that's already here. The alarm tag, when it's set to on, we should get beeps, we should see an LED blinking on F5, we should see the backlight turn amber and then blink between amber and yellow, and we should see a banner message appear across the top. Let's go take a look at the simulator and watch all that come together. So F5 toggles this alarm tag down on the PLC to on. When that happens, sure enough, the screen blinks between yellow and amber. We get a message appearing across the top of the screen. We hear the beeps going, and we see the LED flashing on F5. Let's quiet that down. And finally, when the PLC sets the lock tag, the graphic appears on the screen. That's all there is to setting up alarms. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.